Hi friends, this is Leela. Welcome to my channel Leela Web Dev. Now what we will try to do is we will go little bit deeper into the Redux library. So up to now we have seen how to create the state, okay, store or state, how to dispatch the actions, creating the action creators. These are all the things we have seen. How to save the data in the store, how to get the state data. These are all the things we have seen. Now we will go little bit further. So we will go little bit further means how we can do the asynchronous type of logic in the Redux. Before going to the asynchronous logic in the Redux, we need to know how the Redux library works in the inside. Okay, in the inside core, we need to know how the Redux library works. Then we need to know about the middleware concepts in the Redux, which is available in the Redux. Then after using that middleware, how we can achieve the asynchronous thing, we need to understand. So first, what we'll try to do is we will try to design our own Redux library, how the core of the Redux library works. So now we will go to the JavaScript way of representation of the Redux library. So good olden days, old videos we'll see, we have seen, right? How we can write the Redux, how we can implement the Redux application in a vanilla JavaScript, plain old vanilla JavaScript we have seen. So that is that example, I have opened that example. Now in this example, what we have did is we have used the third party library, that is nothing but the Redux standalone library. So we have used the Redux standalone library, and using this Redux library, we have created a main.js, that is nothing but the store data. Now what I will try to do is, instead of having this one Redux library, we will create our own Redux library. Okay, so we know how the Redux library works. So we will try to create our own Redux library, and we will check whether our core concept is working or not. So now what I will try to do, I will create a new file here, Redux.js. Okay, so now we know that the Redux library, when we are accessing this Redux library, so let's try to copy this one and let's try to add it here. Now here, if you try to see in the main.js, here we are using this create store. So we are creating the store using a method called create store. So what we will try to do now, let's try to create implement the method create store. Okay, so now what I am doing, let's go to the redux.js file, and I am creating function create store. Okay, so now this takes in the main.js, if we try to see, this is taking a reducer. Okay, fine, take the reducer, and also it will also take the preloaded state. So I will show you, it will also take the preloaded state. So that is nothing but the normal state. So let's, what I will try to do, I will store the preloaded state in the state. Okay, so we have the state. And what I will try to do, so now using this create store, so when this create store is created, so we will be able to have three methods: get state, subscribe, and also dispatch. These are the three methods which will be available as soon as you create a store. Okay, fine, those are methods. So let's create function. What is the first one is, what I can say, get state. We will be having the function get state, and another one is the function subscribe. Okay, and another one is the dispatch, function dispatch. Okay, so these are the three methods which is available. So I am returning the three objects, so dispatch, subscribe, and also get state. Okay, so these are the three things which we will be methods which is useful in the file, in the Redux file, as soon as we create a store. Now let's try to do whatever we need to do. So now whenever we are using this get state, means what it will try to do, it will give you the current state of the application. The current state of the application is nothing but the state. So what I can do here, return state. I will just return the state, and that's it. Now when you are subscribing this one, okay, when you are subscribing this one, what I need to do here, subscribe. So when you are subscribing, you are passing a method. Okay, subscribe means subscribe takes a method. So nothing but the method. So what I will try to do, so as soon as, what we need to do, so whenever you are dispatching an action, immediately the subscribe has to execute. The whatever the function you are giving in the subscribe method, we need to execute. Okay, fine, let's try to take these all the things in the one variable, that is nothing but the constant listeners. Okay, normally we'll keep it as a listeners. These listeners are the set of functions which need to be executed as soon as we dispatch an action. You need to remember that. These listeners are nothing but the set of functions which were sent by the subscribe method, So we need to execute all the listeners which are present in the listeners whenever we dispatch an action. So that means what I need to do. So here you will be getting the subscribe. You will be getting a single listener. And what I need to do here, listener dot push of, sorry, listeners, listeners dot push of listener. So whenever a user subscribes, so we are pushing this all render method, this all render function into a array. So this consists of the list of methods. Now somebody dispatched an action. Okay, somebody dispatched an action. So here you'll be able to see, right? So this is an action. So where is that action? Yeah, here is an action. It consists of an action creator. Now whenever somebody dispatches an action, what I need to do? I will get an action. Here what I need to do? So first what I need to do is I need to send it to the red user, this action, right? So I need to send it to the red user, this action along with the state. So why? Because we have already created the red user here. So counter red user, we need to pass the state and also the action. So we have passed the state and the action. And now in return, the counter red user, what it will give you, it will return you the updated state. So what I need to do? So I need to update that state in the existing state variable. So here, what I will try to do? So here I will update the state. Now what I need to do, whenever somebody dispatches an action, I need to execute all the listeners as we already have discussed. So what I need to do? So here I can do something like listeners dot for each. I can loop over each listener. So now I will get a listener and I will execute the listener directly. Okay. So that's it. So we have implemented our simple own Redux library. Now let's try to execute the code. Same code, this one is there, right? So instead of using this Redux, I use this create store. Same thing, that's it. So nothing is there. So this create store function is executing from the Redux.js. And in the index.html, I have removed the Redux library and using our own Redux library. Now let's try to execute the code. So now here I am opening it with the live server. Let's try to see. I am able to see the counter example. If I am incrementing here, it's not working, right? Let's try to see whether we are getting any action. Okay. So here we are able to get that counter of undefined. Okay, fine. We need to pass the, in the main.js, we need to pass the state. So here I will pass the state as counter of 0. So I am passing the initial state. So now if I try to do, okay. So now if I click here, see it is incrementing easily. So now what we have did here, so we have created our own Redux library. So we using this subscribe and all those things. So why I'm explaining you this one is, so now in the Redux library itself, so there is no need to mention this, what I can say, state thing. So the state automatically will be taken from the red user. So when you are passing the red user, so it will be automatically taken. So that who will be taking care is, that is nothing but the enhancer. So those are called as a store enhancer. So store enhancer, what is this one is, so before executing this dispatching thing or before getting the state, if you want to do any action, if you want to perform, for example, you are dispatching an action. Okay. So whenever a store is dispatching, so whenever we are dispatching, we need to execute some method. We need to execute some logic. Whenever in dispatch actions, when you want to execute an logic, you can use the store enhancer concept. So that, and also whenever you are getting a state, when you are getting state from the Redux library. So before getting state, you want to execute some logic. So you want to send some extra data to this along with the state, existing state. So then we can use this one using the enhancers. So in the next video, what we'll try to do is we'll try to use the enhancers concept in our Redux library, how the enhancers will work. Okay. If you have any doubts or any suggestions, please post the comments below to this video. And if you like this video, please do support me by subscribing to my channel. Thank you.